There they are.
What have you done?
Baron, I beg of you.
You have made an enemy of the Empire. You have brought vermin into my house.
I swear, I only wanted to protect us.
Silence!
And the Baron is pissed.
My honored guest, I bow my head in surrender, and I apologize for what's become of Cortes.
I'm here for your wife, Baron. She's committed terrorist offenses against the Empire.
I fought the only way I could. All I ever had was money.
Our reinforcements have arrived. We will attack on your signal.
I knew nothing of my wife's conspiracy. She only confessed once the house defenses were down. But I will make amends. Now, Captain.
He's gonna kill her? Oh, she killed her. Well, that's it. That is actually our mission done. That wasn't necessary. It was. It settled then. Kill everyone.
You're an honorable man. I appreciate your sacrifice.
I had no other choice. Now, take your insects away from this place. We can discuss further recompense as civilized people.
We're afraid that's not your decision, Baron.
Denry Ale and the Baroness are dead. With our assistance, the terrorist funding has been stopped. Now the nest will claim its price.
Oh.
What are you talking about, Vector?
House Cortes will make a perfect extension of the hive. These rooms will become egg chambers and membrosia pools. The family can become joiners.
What? You cannot do this! I gave you my wife!
House Cortes opposed the Empire and must be subdued. The nest is growing and must expand its territory.
Yeah, this was definitely not part of our deal. Let's sit down and discuss.
There's no reason we can't talk this through.
We don't understand. By allowing the Kilix to absorb House Cortes, both the Empire and the Nest benefit. Why would you object?
Forcing people to join the Nest is wrong. Can't you understand that?
The joining is part of the Kilik way. How can that be wrong? Agent, I must know if you intend to oppose us. If you do, the Nest will fight to defend its claim.
Now he must be under some influence. No.
I'm not letting you take these people.
Very well, we understand. And our loyalty to the Empire comes first. We hope your decision is the right one.
Men, defend the Baron!
I don't want them to. I rather take them under Imperial rule. If I can make them join the Empire, then fair enough. But not this way. This was not part of our deal. Big guy.
Hey,
The Nest has withdrawn. House Cortez is safe. For now.
You turned on the Nest. That couldn't have been easy.
The Nest transformed us into the Dawn Herald. The Nest gave us peace and understanding. But we were always the Empire's emissary.
I am grateful for your aid. House Cortez has suffered enough.
No, it has not. This is not it. You serve us now.
The Empire will expect your cooperation in the future.
I assure you, House Cortez will make restitution.
Baron, perhaps you'd allow us to access your computers. We are certain our superiors would like to see the Baroness's files.
Captain Perovius, arrange it. I must see to our defenses in case anyone else would take advantage of our humbled state.
Is the Watcher 2?
This is Keeper to Cipher 9. I'm receiving your transmission. Watchers are reviewing the Cortez logs now. It looks like you've wrapped up the terrorist financing situation. Congratulations.
I'm proud to be of service, sir.
Preliminary analysis suggests the Eagle's terror network will run low on funds within weeks. The cells will look for alternative credit sources, of course. Let's not give them the chance to find any.
We'll keep them on the run. Anything else?
One other thing. Mm-hmm. I contacted Vector's superiors in the diplomatic service, and we've reached an agreement.
Sir?
Your requisition has been made permanent. You've been officially transferred to Imperial Intelligence. Cipher 9, from now on, Vector Hellas will act as a covert assault agent under your command. Understood?
And do we have to... Can we fix his eyes?
Understood. Welcome aboard, Vector.
We'll do our best to live up to expectations.
Once you're through on Alderaan, return to your ship for debriefing. Watcher 2 should have updates ready for you. In the meantime, instruct Vector as you see fit. I expect he'll require additional training.
You'll be a superior agent in no time.
Good. Stay alert, Cipher. Keep her out.
Agent? We are grateful for this opportunity. After fighting the Nest, we don't think we can return to the Hive.
Don't thank me. Keeper made the choice.
We understand. We are grateful nonetheless, and we will serve, both as Dawn Herald and as operative of Imperial Intelligence.
No. Leave those ants. We don't want anything to do with the ants. Right, but now we're done here. So I think it is time to wrap up chapter 1. Let's get rid of all these. Don't need them anymore. They were actually very useless. No surprise. And now we just need to prepare ourselves for Hoth. We have Quesh as well. And Taris.
All right, we've got a problem. I told you about my ex-partners, how they decided to come after me. Well, that's fine. I can deal with that. What's not fine is when random freaking bounty hunters come after me because they smell a trend.
Who's coming after you, Kalia?
Guy's called The Menace. Never worked with him, never dated him, never heard of him. He's tracking me down. Apparently got a rep as a duelist. Probably wants to auction me to anyone with a grudge.
You went after Anspichel to auction her off?
I nabbed her because it was personal. The money was just sense. Look, we need to do something. Get a little aggressive. You in?
Tell me what you need and you've got it.
Not totally sure yet, but I'll let you know when I've got a plan. You and me, we're gonna get these people.
As long as it isn't Nar Shaddaa.
This is Watcher 2 to Cipher 9. Verify that you're receiving and prepare for takeoff. We've located the Eagle.
Perfect.
Watcher 2, you're fantastic.
I certainly am. And you're going to love this. We knew the Eagle had abandoned his old base, but until you neutralized that last cell, we didn't know the details. Now we do. The Eagle is on Hutter. Get there as soon as you can.
Oh.
It all comes back to the beginning.
For you, at least. I have to go now, Cipher, but I'll brief you on site. Watcher 2 out.
Yeah. There we go. Right. We have some dialogue then. More of that. Vector.
Agent, we're finalizing our exit report for the diplomatic service. 34 pages of seating charts, ambassador profiles, and appendices. We'll transmit it to our superiors, and then we're yours full time.
You're going to be an asset to this team, Vector.
We certainly hope so. You know, we used to advise first contact missions to new star systems. We met some unusual people, but we haven't had many new experiences since joining the Kilix. Time to broaden our horizons.
To see everything fresh, from a Kilix perspective.
Something of the sort. Tastes, sounds, smells. They're all a bit different. But we won't bore you. Lead the way.
That's it. That's the only dialogue he had.
Hey, I know I've been busy, but when are you gonna buy me that drink?
What drink?
Something going on? Or are you just feeling friendly?
Little of both. I know how you treat girls on missions. You see someone you want, you go after her and make her want you too.
It's a fun game
for
that?
A while, but we both can play better. You agree?
Oh, wait. Yeah, I remember now. But apart from the Baroness, we had that one in the cantina in Drummond Cars for information. This woman is dangerous.
I like a game that has challenge.
So let's take a walk and find a cantina.
No, wait. Not. Okay, good.
You don't know how to dance and hold a gun? I can show you sometime. Have to call it a night for now, though.
Did something go wrong? Another time, then. I guess we can actually romance her here. I don't know. I mean, she's just after, I don't know, whatever suits her. Another time. I don't even know if we're gonna get any other companions, like, that we can romance. I do admit, I do like her humor.
We don't have to. I'm sure the mission can wait.
Hey, it's been fun, but the mood's long gone. Get going before you bore me.
That's great. 520. I guess this dialogue's done. Everything is done. So let's finish chapter one. There should only be one mission then. I hope this chapter's gone on long enough. Oh wait, I forgot.
Signal received, transmission secure. All right, Cipher. Looks like this is the real thing. Ready to invade the Eagle's Nest?
You better believe it.
The Eagle and his men are holed up in an old refinery beneath the river. Sending coordinates now. You'll lead the forward assault, but military reinforcements will surround the base and follow you in. Primary objective is to capture or eliminate the Eagle himself.
So, okay, we can capture him or eliminate him.
Acknowledged and understood.
Your secondary objective is the Eradicators. The terrorists have begun launching their biomechanical weapons over Imperial worlds. Once the devices are ready, the terrorists can fire on cities and military bases from orbit.
We'll find a way to stop them.
I hope so. After the Dominator, everyone who died along with Darth Jadus, I don't want to go through that again. When you're in that base, don't let anyone escape. Don't let the Eagle murder again. Watcher 2 out.
Well, in order to guarantee that, I have to take him out. Simple as that. This is the way out, isn't it? So the question is only then where on Hutto?
Take it slowly.
Down there, but we don't have anything to get closer, so we're gonna have to get there on foot or by on speeder in this case, unless no, that won't work. Okay. So hold on. Right, let's go. Let's see if we can get some answers. There is a thing. Right, here we're gonna have to kill.
Increasing combat pheromone. Farewell.
Hey, rise and shine.
Sir, we're cut off. Thurston and Gerald tried to get out, but the Imperials are all over the swamps.
They would be. Damnation. I promised Gerald she'd die with the detonator in one hand and a glass of brandy in the other. Seems she's made a liar of me.
I'm sorry, sir.
Don't be. You were everything I could have hoped for. Now carve us a path out. I'll follow soon. All right, I see you. The least I could do was send the boy off with hope. But have you seen the strength of the revolution? Cells on Nar Shaddaa, Tholot and Molovar, Alderaan, Balmora. It's an inspiration, no matter how it ends.
Your inspiration is terrorism. Plain and simple.
Nothing is plain or simple about terrorism, about rebellion, or about covert intelligence. That's your field, I presume. You don't look military. Tell me something. How much of my story has the Empire uncovered? What have your methods found?
We found out all about your little orbital weapons, your eradicators.
Look behind me. That is an eradicator. Technology developed on Dromon Kass and Balmora. They can be grown anywhere. 6 dozen are already in place. They'll wait to receive orders, at first. But eventually, without commands, they'll run rampant. Fire blindly at cities from orbit.
Is bluffing?
The eradicators are worthless. Without you, the threat ends.
You're not enough of a fool to believe that. Uncontrolled, the eradicators won't hit our targets, but chaos and death still send a message. Now we're done. May whoever survives see a glorious future for the Empire.
And we need this one too. Great, we need that one too.
Seeing you, I didn't think it would happen like this. But as I said, it makes no difference. The Eradicators will run rampant, the Empire will burn, and you have been betrayed.
What?
Who's betrayed me?
My patron. The one who showed me how to unite the cells, proposed the Eradicators, is one of your own people. A traitor in your empire has been helping us all along. Your civilization is so corrupt that it's destroying itself.
Give me a name.
If I had one, I might. But I never learned the truth. Goodbye now. Watch me burn.
Detonator, get back!
Area is clear. Sir, are you all right?
Cipher 9, it's Watcher 3. Are you hurt? That was a nasty explosion.
A little singed, but better than the Eagle.
That really was him? Fantastic. Keeper sent me to assist with information retrieval, slicing the Eagle's computers. I'll also check out that device there. I think it's an Eradicator.
Move fast. The Eradicators may still be a threat.
Yes, sir. Cipher, I've got some preliminary findings. It's not good news. I overheard what the Eagle said. Looks like he was telling the truth. If no one gives the Eradicators new orders, they'll go mad. Fire randomly.
That's bad.
Any idea how to disable them?
Here's the good part. I figured out their control mechanism. Transmit the proper codes, and you can set the device's targets, disable them, anything. The Eagle stored half the control codes on his computers. Someone else must have the second half.
The Eagle mentioned a patron.
Yes, sir. The one inside the Empire. I'm not sure what that means. You should head to Drummond Cass. I don't think there's anything more you can do here, and Keeper wants you back at headquarters.
Alright, Drummond Cass is next. We're then just gonna teleport to Drummond Cass. We're going to Keeper, so we should be going here. Imperial Intelligence.
Rise and shine.
Thank you.
Rise and shine.
Cipher 9, come inside. This should be a triumphant moment. It's a tremendous achievement bringing down the Eagle. The crisis has only escalated. The Eradicators could begin firing at any moment.
What's our current status?
Watcher 2, your report.
The Moths have placed local forces on alert, and a search for the Eradicators is underway. Unfortunately, trends suggest we can only find one device every 5 hours. It'll be weeks before we destroy them all.
Disappointing, but not a surprise. Damage projections?
Estimates are 10 to 50 million deaths on each planet targeted. 40% military, 60% civilian.
Oh, that's not also good.
Even at the low end, that's unacceptable.
Agreed. It sends the message that the Empire is vulnerable.
In order to deactivate the Eradicators en masse, we need the control codes. Half the codes were on the Eagle's computers. We can only surmise that the other half are with the Eagle's patron.
Yes, the patron. The man whom the Eagle claims is inside the Empire.
Any idea who it could be?
I have my doubt that this patron is really a highly placed Imperial. It seems unlikely such a person could escape our scrutiny. Nonetheless, we can't ignore the possibility of a traitor. That's why we're meeting privately. Only the people in this room know the full situation.
Caution would seem prudent.
Indeed. Watcher 2?
The Eagle had been sending periodic transmissions to someone in the Artus system. Artus is uninhabited, devoid of resources and off the major hyperlanes. Our patron could certainly hide there.
I want you to lead a mission to Artus. You're to find the Eagle's patron and obtain his half of the control codes. Watcher 2 will rendezvous with you there. She knows more about the Eradicators than anyone.
I'll be glad to have her around. We'll get the job done.
Your ships will be outfitted with cloaking devices. They'll only last one jump, but they'll get you into Artus unnoticed. After that, infiltrate whatever base the patron is using. Recover the Eradicator control codes and stop the threat. Watcher 2, you're dismissed.
All right.
If you want to talk before the mission, I'll be at my station.
There is one more thing. Darth Zored heard you were returning to Drummond Cass. She wants to speak to you.
She's insane, you know that, right?
Yes, I know. I've done my best to shield intelligence from our new lord. You've been the unfortunate exception. Do what it takes to survive Zored's attentions a little longer. Beyond that, the Dark Council won't let this continue forever.
What?
What's that supposed to mean?
It means that even the Dark Council will police its members if the damage is great enough. When you're through, head to the Artus system. This is our only chance, Cipher. Fail, and we all pay a grievous cost.
Oh, I don't want to go and speak to her. What about Watcher 2? That's not really what we want. She's not coming with us. She's staying here, right? What will we tell Zored? Zored? Zored?
They're scared of you here, aren't they?
Trauma includes electrical burns, lacerations, and retinal damage. Transfer to a Colto tank for long-term recovery is strongly recommended.
You suggest a Dark Council member hide in a vat? For healing?
I am programmed to dispense medical advice based on all relevant factors.
Get out! Have yourself disassembled made into a probe and sent to the most desolate place in the Empire. Look, Agent, they hurt me, and then they laughed. How could they?
They?
Who did, my lord?
After Viorianal broke, I called the Council to assembly. I demanded the lords give me the respect I was due. Some were angry, mocked me. They tormented me and warned me not to overstep my bounds again.
The Dark Council did this.
They called me an arrogant child, unworthy of my position.
That's
it's
true.
It's all Jadis' fault. He was my master, but he never taught me what I needed to know. Now he's dead, and I'm not ready for his council seat.
Yeah, then leave the council.
If you're not fit for the responsibility, you should abdicate.
All my enemies would strike at me then, and all Jadis's too. I know what's happening in Imperial Intelligence. I know you're going on a mission, and that the Eagle wasn't the man you thought. Swear that you'll find whoever really killed my father. Swear that the man responsible will pay for forcing me into this wretched life.
Sure.
I swear I will make him pay.
Yes. You will exact my revenge. And the world will be made right. I have gifts for you, Agent. Take them with my blessing and leave me to salt my wounds. And to gain strength from my hatred.
And where's my gifts? They're not here. Well, I definitely think we're gonna have to be starting Chapter 2 tomorrow. This one took a long time. A very long time. It's just a ship. It's just a ship. Meet with Watcher 2 on the Arthur's Dreadnought. Oh no, she's here. Okay. I don't know if I can trust Watcher 2 now. Why is she here? Why now? Why now?
Rise and shine.